What is going on, everyone? Welcome to my channel. My name is Gyasi Linje. I am a full-time software developer and part-time YouTuber. And in today's video, I'm gonna be talking about what is on my Dell XPS 15. Some months ago, I did a what's on my MacBook Pro video, and you all really enjoyed that video. I got a lot of good feedback. So I decided to make a what's on my Dell XPS 15 video because this is my personal laptop. And for those of you all who follow me on Instagram, it's probably a little bit confusing because you see me using a MacBook Pro when it comes to some of my Instagram stories and posts, but that is a 15-inch MacBook Pro. It's not the 16-inch. I don't have that laptop anymore, but the 15-inch is my main workhorse for front-end development for my full-time job. And let's be honest, MacBook Pros are great for aesthetics. Yes, I am a content creator and a software developer, but I'm pretty chill. Don't expect anything too crazy. For those of you all who are wondering which version of the XPS 15 this is the 7590 version that came out in June of 2019. And yes, I'm very interested in that 15 and 17 inch Dell XPS 15 2020 model that is supposed to be coming out soon. As a content creator, you're gonna see apps that I utilize to create thumbnails for my YouTube videos, video editing, amongst other productivity apps that help me create content for YouTube. And as a software developer, you're gonna see more of like the technical applications that some of you all have might not even heard of, and some of you all who are software developers, you might have heard of them because they're pretty popular apps. First apps that we're gonna talk about is the web browser. Actually, I really only use one web browser, and it's Google Chrome. The reason being is because Chrome is really reliable and I love using the inspect tools when it comes to software development. Funny thing is, I used to use Firefox more than any other browser when I was in college because it was a lot more reliable when it came to taking online courses with Blackboard. But now that I'm out of college, Google Chrome is my go-to. The inspect tool is really powerful. I can easily see whatever I console logged from my software development program. I can inspect elements, and I can also easily toggle between screen sizes for what my web apps would look like on different devices. And does anyone use Internet Explorer or Edge anyways? These next few apps I'm gonna talk about are gonna be focused on content creation. And the first app I wanna talk about is Cloud App. This is something that I talked about in my It's on My MacBook Pro video, but it's something I still use to this day. Honestly, it's one of the easiest ways to screen record and take screenshots on your PC. I know there's snipping tool, which is great for taking screenshots, but whenever you want to screen record or get video of your screen, Cloud App is really reliable. There's only one complaint I have. I know that you're allowed to share things instantly, but not really. It does take a little bit of time for the videos to actually upload, so you can actually download them or get the shareable link, but it's not that big of a deal. It's still pretty fast, but it would be nice if it was a little bit faster, especially as someone who's creating YouTube videos and needing to get those video files quickly. Next up I want to talk about is the Creative Cloud desktop application. I'm only going to talk about it for a second because I rather talk more about the actual application within the Creative Cloud suite. But this is something that's nice to have because you can easily install applications that you need for whatever content creation or creative tasks that you have at hand. I personally only use a few of these Creative Cloud applications, but I do have access to the full suite of applications. And if you are someone like myself who has access to that, I do recommend having the Creative Cloud desktop application so you can easily install or uninstall applications that you don't need. Obviously, I make YouTube videos, so my go-to video editing software is Premiere Pro, which is the first Creative Cloud app that I want to talk about because it is the app that I use the most. And I first use iMovie, which is typical for someone who has a macOS computer and starts doing video editing or creating YouTube videos. And then after a few months, I decided to upgrade to Premiere Pro. I'll never forget, it was like fall of 2017. It was my senior year of college, and I was using the 5K IMAX in the library, and I just fell in love with video editing. I found Premiere Pro a little bit intimidating because I didn't really have any experience with video editing software outside of iMovie. But once I learned how to navigate the menu system and understood how to do color grading, I fell in love with video editing and I really enjoy Premiere Pro. Next app that I wanna talk about is Lightroom. Lightroom, I did say Premiere Pro is what I use the most. Premiere Pro is, I'd say, it's not the most. Lightroom is what I use the most. And the reason being is because I really do enjoy photography. Lightroom is what I use for my YouTube thumbnails, and I use it for all of my photo editing, whether it's for me personally that I'm not even gonna put out there for the world to see, or for Instagram and Instagram stories. Lightroom is a cloud-based photo service, and what I love about it is that it automatically updates any photos that I import no matter what device I'm using. So one frustration I have using the XPS is that I can't AirDrop from my iPhone. I'm very much integrated into the Mac ecosystem, and it has been pretty frustrating not being able to AirDrop back and forth from my laptop. But since Lightroom is a cloud-based service, let's say I import a photo from my camera to my phone and I start doing some editing there, I can pick up where I left off on my XPS and vice versa. Also with Lightroom, I find the user experience really easy to use. I'm not a Photoshop guy by any means. Yes, I use it a lot for work, but I definitely prefer Lightroom. I also think they're very different workflows, where Lightroom is more so color grading and adding filters and creating presets for your Instagram stories. So yes, I use Lightroom on an almost daily basis for Instagram stories. You can easily copy and paste settings from one photo to another, which I find really convenient for my Instagram. That's on my XPS is Photoshop. Photoshop is like, I don't know. I just feel like you gotta have it, because sometimes you need to make updates or you need to manipulate your photos. So I think of Lightroom as more like creating my filters and presets, like I just mentioned, but I think of Photoshop as more of manipulating my photos. Like sometimes there's like a cord or some sort of object that is in a photo that I don't want, so I can mask and I can crop and do a bunch of other things. Photoshop is a lot more powerful when it comes to manipulating your photos opposed to Lightroom. So Photoshop is my go-to when I wanna make my thumbnail look perfect, or I just wanna manipulate it in some sort of way. The next app that I have is Adobe XD, and Adobe XD has become my favorite UI UX design software. And honestly, it's like my playground to be creative in a way that I don't normally get a chance to be creative. Even though, okay, so I do work as a digital front-end developer, so obviously I'm in XD all the time, but I'm not actually creating the user experience or building out like those assets on XD. My job is to take the assets from XD, or actually not even take the assets from XD for the most part, but more so looking at what the website or mobile app should look like and translating that into code. I used to be a big Figma user. I still am a big fan of Figma and love it, but I just enjoy having all my creative content centralized into one space with Adobe Creative Cloud. And I'm not gonna lie, a lot of the keys that I use in Premiere Pro, Lightroom, and Photoshop, not a ton, but a couple, I use in XD, so the workflow is just seamless. So there are a couple collaborative features that Adobe XD has that I enjoy, and you can easily create artboards for whatever application you're designing for. So whenever I have an idea of building an app, what I usually do is, the first thing I do is I go to XD and I design a couple of the pages, like the splash page and the authorization pages, so the login, sign up, home pages, and then I start coding from there. An application that makes honorable mention, and there's no desktop version for it from what I know, and that application is Adobe Spark. Adobe Spark is something that I use for my thumbnails. So after I finish adding a preset or color grading my thumbnails and manipulating them with Photoshop, the next thing I do is I add text overlay with Adobe Spark. I know some of you all are probably like, why not use Photoshop? Because sometimes Photoshop can be complicated and I need to drop my video before a certain time. So Spark is really reliable. You can easily go back to projects that you've used before that have the specific ratio that you need for your thumbnails, along with the font families that you use for your thumbnails. I was exposed to Adobe Spark back in college when I had to create newsletters. So you can also create newsletters, blog posts, Instagram stories, and channel art. So now that we talked about the content creation apps that I use all the time, let's talk about some of the productivity apps and entertainment apps that are on my XPS. So the first app I want to talk about is the Mail app. This is probably my most used application outside of obviously something like Google Chrome. And I love this app because it centralizes all of my email accounts. I don't have a ton, but I do have quite a few Gmail accounts. How I basically break up my Gmail accounts is I have one for signing up for like newsletters and, you know, getting promo codes for when I wanna shop online. I have one old Gmail account that I'm trying to phase out and delete at some point. And then I have another Gmail account that I use for all of my business matters. MailApp is a great way to centralize your email accounts. You can toggle between accounts really easily. You can add your Outlook account, you can add your Office 365 account, your Gmail account, Yahoo, and iCloud accounts. XPS, unlike the MacBook Pro, doesn't have like a note app that's built in, at least not from what I know. There's like Notepad, but honestly, no one uses that besides like hardcore developers, and it doesn't have the best experience. So for my notes, I just use Microsoft OneNote. Again, another cloud-based application that allows me to keep track of my notes no matter what device I'm using. Not a whole lot to say about OneNote. Obviously, the experience is great. It works similarly to Microsoft Word, just a note version. I have Outlook on my XPS, but I don't use that ever. Another application that I have is Microsoft Teams. I don't use Teams a lot. Sometimes I do need to use it I use it all the time for work. What I mean is I don't use it all the time for my personal machine, but Teams is a reliable way to collaborate through video. Someone who's used Zoom and Skype, and Teams is by far the best experience. It's much easier to join online meetings. It's easier to share things through the chat. It just has a better experience than Skype and Zoom. Microsoft Excel is another application that's on my machine, and I just started using this application more than usual. The reason being is because I really do like the spreadsheets. They're pretty simple to use and make calculations for. My main usage of Microsoft Excel is for my net worth calculator. So basically, I just keep track of my debt to income ratio, and I don't really keep track of expenditures. On my XPS, I do that more so on my phone through Clarity and the Chase mobile banking app. But Excel is a great way for me to keep track of my holistic financial picture. I also have used Excel for Python programming. So I'm literally just going through the start page on my XPS. There are a number of apps on here that I really don't use that already were downloaded on my machine. So now that we talked about some of those productive applications that I use, let's talk about the entertainment ones really, really quickly. I mean, I have Netflix, Spotify, and Hulu on my XPS. I'm not a huge like consumer of shows on laptops for some reason, even though this 4K OLED display is beautiful. It's something that I don't do. I don't do it on my phone either. I'd rather just watch shows on a large TV. But those are the three applications that I use on my XPS for entertainment, or at least have on my XPS for entertainment. Okay, so the next set of applications that I'm gonna talk about are the applications that I use for software development. When it comes to software development, there's only one IDE I use, at least personally. Now for work, I use two. I use Visual Studio Code and I use Visual Studio. But personally on this XPS, I use Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code is amazing. You can actually learn more about it if you click this link where I talk about the software development apps that I use for front-end development. But to briefly talk about Visual Studio Code, I think of Visual Studio Code is like a lightweight version of Visual Studio, and you can easily download extensions for whatever programming language you're using, so you can like beautify. And you wanna do that so Visual Studio Code knows what kind of program language you're using, so it can do IntelliSense. So if it knows it's an HTML page, and you type div and you hit enter, it'll actually create a div tag for you. And that's just one example. But you can easily integrate Git with Visual Studio Code. There's a terminal at the bottom where you can run Git commands, and you can actually run other command line interface tools to add resources to Visual Studio and to your application. So you can do everything in Visual Studio. You can code in Visual Studio and you can use it as a terminal. Next application that I use on my XPS is Git Bash. The reason why I use Git Bash is because I had a lot of experience using it when I worked as a full stack developer, and I like the experience a lot more, and the command line keys are very similar to the terminal in the Mac. I noticed that in like the command prompt in Windows, I think Explorer or whatever it's called, basically the terminals that are built into the XPS don't have the same commands that the terminal has in the Mac OS. So GitBash is just an easy way for me to navigate files and create projects that I need for software development. And obviously you use it to clone repos and do whatever you need to do within version control. And the last application I want to talk about is Postman, which is an app that allows me to make API requests really easily. So I use Postman a lot. I use it within my job now, but I used to use it a ton, nearly every day in my old job. So Postman allows you to make API requests. And this is a good way to see if you're actually accessing the API you need to access before you even start writing code, because sometimes your API request works, but your code is wrong. So you're not getting the response you're expecting. So it's your fault and not the API's fault. So this basically allows you to extrapolate your API call from your code. So you know, hey, the API is working, now I can start programming. And API calls is a huge part of software development. So that's my rant on Postman. A little bit nerdy. Some of you all probably have no idea what I'm talking about, but if you become a software developer, this will become your best friend. All right, so with that being said, that concludes this video. Thank you all for watching this video. I really appreciate it. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it all. Comment down below what's on your MacBook Pro or what's on your XPS or whatever laptop or desktop that you use. Share with someone who you think might benefit from it. And I'm praying that you and your families are staying safe and healthy. I hope this video was helpful. And as always, have a blessed rest of your week. I'll see you all soon. Peace.